what should have been a fairly boring book, right? On our annual observance of Christmas, it's been sort of domesticated, maybe even exploited. But something about those opening sentences to that book startled me awake from the mundane observance of Christianity and compelled me to share the good news of Jesus Christ with the passion and the significance for such a monumental event, namely the arrival of Jesus. Paul must have had a similar experience that I did, because in chapter 4, he writes another commanding statement. When the fullness of time had come, he says. For us, time is sort of a linear movement. There's nothing really new under the sun. Empires rise and fall, children are born, and elders die. But according to St. Paul, something significant occurred in a back alley barn of Bethlehem, on the hillsides of Galilee, and on a Roman cross outside the city of Jerusalem. When the fullness of time had come, writes Paul, God sent forth his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem all those who were under the law, that they might receive adoption. The same God who called Abraham to leave his hometown and his kindred, the same God who stretched out his mighty hand and arm to deliver the Israelites from slavery in Egypt, the same God who watched the nation of Israel flounder under insufficient kings, it was this same God who chose to intervene in human history in such a vital and striking way. He didn't go off picking a different kind of people. He did not send a different king or another empire. This time, at this very moment, God sent his very own to redeem his people once and for all and to bless the nations of the earth through faith in the Son of God. Up until this point, God had dealt with his people through the law, through guardians and managers of people's behavior. That's why he gave them kings and judges and priests and summoned superpowers to rule over them. But the law and its associates can only take us so far. While it supports the peace of the world and among peoples, the law cannot save us from sin and death. Before Christ's coming, the law of Moses had gained the upper hand and imprisoned everyone under the bondage of sin. All the while,